Hi, I'm John Malice. Welcome to this live edition of Connect with me on the showroom floor at Ventura TV on this Tuesday morning. Today, we're talking about the shortage of blood supply here in the Central Valley. We'll have the CEO of the Central California Blood Center in the house live. You'll be able to take your phone calls at 436-ME-TV, option 11. Do call in. Sam Suits and Tuxedos, our sponsor on the program today. Back in a moment. It is a Your Community segment here today on Connect with Me on MeTV Fresno, but could very easily be also a business segment because obviously the Blood Center is a nonprofit organization, but you can donate blood, you can donate money, whatever you possibly can to help out the Blood Center. We'll talk about that during the course of the program today. But first, I want to do a little programming note. And tomorrow's program, Ronnie Paul is going to be here. We'll talk about the passing of Mary Tyler Moore, and also we'll talk about the man that was from Fresno that played in the television series from 1967 to 1975, and that's called Mannix. Mike Connors, of course, was from Fresno. He passed along with another star that you see here on MeTV. We'll tell you who that is during the course of the program tomorrow. Then on Thursday, we'll talk about teen suicide with somebody from Children's Hospital. That'll be an interesting program. We've had more than a dozen, or about a dozen, in Valley schools in the past year or so, so a very serious topic. Meantime, you're watching us live on Comcast Channel 375, as usual. If you don't have Comcast Xfinity, as we like to call it, you can watch us on 43.6 or 13.1 over-the-air broadcast with a digital antenna Monday through Friday, live 10 to 11 o'clock in the morning. Then the replay comes later in the day. Two more occasions you have a chance to watch this program. Over-the-air broadcast, 13.6 at 2 o'clock in the afternoon, and 8 o'clock tonight, 4.6 Biz TV. After that, it's going to be on YouTube. Some overnight news about the superintendent at Fresno Unified. Let's put his picture up on the screen, tell you what I'm talking about. Fresno Unified School District fired its superintendent, Michael Hansen, at a special meeting last night. Hansen, who led the district for 12 years, was under fire for a federal probe into the leaseback program and for his use of a CyberDust app that erased text messages within a couple of minutes. His last day on the job is going to be tomorrow instead of sometime in August. By the way, Bob Nelson was named the acting superintendent until a permanent superintendent is found sometime in the near future. All right, time to talk about the Central California Blood Center, and it is in real trouble. That, according to the CEO, we're not in a crisis yet, according to him, but we are getting pretty close, and it's getting extremely fragile, according to him. I want to put a picture up on the screen. You'll recognize her, Jenny Eller. The Blood Center out there is named after her. She died of leukemia back in October of 1995 at the tender age of 21 years old. She was an outstanding softball player at Bullard High School. Change it. And the Blood Center has about one day's worth of blood supply on hand. That's one of the locations. Usually there are about 3 days' supply on hand. Anyone who can is urged to donate to the Blood Center located at Herndon and Blythe in northwest Fresno. Heavy early morning fog and heavy rain in recent weeks has kept a lot of people away. How important is the Blood Center? You'll see in this report.
Dean Eller, President and CEO, Central California Blood Center. Most blood centers across the country, us included, have anywhere from a half a day supply to usually a maximum of 3 days supply of blood at any given time. It takes at least 48 hours to test the blood and get it ready for the hospital. So you can see that on any given day, we have to meet our goals to collect the blood that we need, or there's going to be a problem. And it's our responsibility to make sure that it's collected, tested, into the hospitals, and ready to go when you have an emergency.
Leslie Bowdus, Central California Blood Center Director of Community Relations. Every single donor who comes in the door must feel that they're being loved in the door and back out again. We know that donors are giving not only their blood, but their time. When one gives blood, they give their time, they give their commitment, they give their really caring about the public health of our community. We have to remember that blood goes from a donor to a patient, and that patient has a great chance of living because of them.
I'm Steve Nagin, and I'm the technical director for the laboratory at Central California Blood Center. Everything is brought back here, whether it's one of our other fixed sites in Fresno or Visalia, or when we go out on mobiles to businesses or schools or churches. Everything's brought back to this location for processing, and then after it's all the processing is completed, it's distributed from here as well. Once it comes back to the laboratory, the blood is manufactured into the various products that we need. If you look at all the different products, we make about 50 different products routinely from either blood or platelet collections. We separate the plasma from the red cells. We make the various red cell products, the various plasma products. That's half of it. The other half is we have to test the donation to make sure that it's disease-free. And we test for those things that can be transmitted through blood transfusion. We're going to test for the virus that causes AIDS, for example. We tested for hepatitis B, hepatitis C. We also test for syphilis, because that can be transmitted through blood transfusion. We also test it for Chagas disease, West Nile virus. We also test for the antibodies that can cause transfusion reactions when blood is given to a recipient if it isn't compatible. And then, of course, we do a blood type on every donation as well. Make sure they're disease-free before being sent off to the hospitals. We test using very highly automated systems. We have to follow what's called good manufacturing practices. We're actually looked at by the inspecting agencies as a pharmaceutical manufacturing plant, so we have to make sure that everything is done in the correct way every time. Well, the red cells are good for 42 days from donation. The plasma, when it's frozen, is good for 1 year from donation. Platelets have the shortest shelf life. They're only good for 5 days from the date of collection.
All right, live in our studio right now is Dean Eller. He is the CEO and the chief cook and bottle washer over there at the Central California Blood Center. I'm glad you're here, Dean. He is here to take your phone calls. He is the father of one Jenny Eller, who passed away so many years ago of leukemia, sadly, in the blood center named after her out there at Herndon and Blythe. They have two other locations. We'll talk about that during today's program. And they have all kinds of mobile units out there in the community, you know, where people can go to these units and give blood, and it's sent out to be tested as well. Dean is here. Glad you're there. 436-ME-TV, option 11. The blood center is in short supply of blood, so go out there and give blood if you possibly can. Today's program is sponsored by Sam Suits and Tuxedos out in Clovis. Back in a moment.
Nothing better than showing up to your next big event in a new suit or tuxedo. Sam's Men's Suits and Tuxedo Shop on Clovis Avenue, just south of Old Town Clovis, has provided a wide selection of custom-tailored fine suits and accessories for over 25 years. Right now, get two suits, two shirts, two ties, and a pair of shoes for only $199. Act now and get a third suit for only $50 more. Stop by or call 559-298-6063 to schedule your fitting today at Sam's Men's Suits and Tuxedo Shop.
Find movies on Over the Air Channel 13.3. Movies. Our name says it all.
Back here on the program, talking about the Blood Center in Fresno, and it's located, the main branch is located at Herndon and Blythe. That's in northwest Fresno. It opened up back in 2009. It's a gorgeous building. Dean Eller is here, the CEO of the Blood Center. Welcome, Dean. Good morning.
Thanks, John.
So how many square feet of footage are we talking about that? I know it was built in 19 or finished in 2009. Mm-hmm. And so what are we talking about? It's huge out there.
Under the main facility is about 64,000 square feet.
Wow. In fact, let's take a peek at a piece of videotape. It's called Inside the Blood Center. It's got no sound. We'll talk over it. So it's just inside. No people giving blood at this time. But we can take a look at the inside just as you walk through the front doors there. And you had just, you know, the idea of building this with Jenny in mind, obviously, right?
Well, we had what we had in mind was taking care of the community. Jenny was a person who had a heart for blood donation because her body didn't make blood, and she had to have blood donors keep her alive with several transfusions each and every week just to make it into the next week.
And look how much space you have here for many donors to come in at one time.
Well, and the old facility that we had was just so cramped and so old and dated that we knew we needed a state-of-the-art new facility. Fresno deserved it. The people of the Central Valley deserved it. And we put it together, and boy, things were just great. And the day we moved in, it was debt-free.
Right. And are you updating the facility as time goes on?
Constantly.
Really?
We're constantly upgrading the facility. We're constantly bringing in new technologies to test blood, to how to draw blood, to even the little rockers underneath the chair that rocks your blood while it's coming out. Those kinds of things are done constantly.
Yeah, and that costs money.
It all costs money. And thankfully, the because of efficiencies in operations and the generosity of the Fresno and Central Valley donors, we've been able to do all of this and pay for it as we go. And so we have no debt.
What did that building cost?
The building and the land together with some of the equipment was about $20 million that it cost. And we put all that together.
All through donations?
It was all through efficiencies in operations, so we were able to cut some costs in operations that saved us some money, and then donations. In your pre-program, you showed the Vincent Isnardi Laboratory, and that gentleman, wonderful gentleman that loved the Blood Center, was 90-plus years old when he came in and handed us a personal check for $1 million to help that lab.
Yeah, and right now you're debt-free.
We're debt-free.
Oh, nothing on the building at all or the land?
Nothing on the building, the land, or any of the equipment. And we have millions of dollars worth of equipment inside because we have to continue to upgrade and update that constantly.
All right. I said in the monologue that basically the CEO, that being you, is not calling this a crisis yet, but what are you calling it?
Well, it's an extreme need. You know, we've heard a lot of things about extremes, and this really is an extreme time, not only for us, but for every blood center across the country. And I don't think most people realize that every blood center is struggling right now.
Why?
Well, I think it's a combination of things. It certainly you have the cold and flus that are going on right now. There's a lot of that going on. People get this cough and it just doesn't go away for weeks or sometimes months. So that's part of it. Obviously, the amount of trauma that you have, traumas, accidents, some things have. But travel restrictions are taking things. We have Zika now. There's all kinds of new types of things that are deferring donors each and every day. And we test like that because we are concerned about the safety of our patients in Valley hospitals. And those things take away. So we want to be safe, not sorry. And so we're very conservative in whom we allow to donate.
All right, let's roll a videotape called Equipment. And in terms of blood shortage, how short are you?
Well, it's, you know, we like to keep at least a minimum of 3 days supply. We are at about a 1 day supply right now. And again, and we would not be at a 1 day supply with one major trauma, with one major accident, with one major shooting. Those are the kinds of things that can take us down very, very quickly. And so we are at a place where we have no margin for error right now.
So you're talking if there was one major accident at, say, heaven forbid, at, say, Shaw and Blackstone, where several people were injured and they needed blood transfusions, you'd be in trouble.
It would depend upon the type
or it would put a strain.
It would put a strain on us, certainly. Yeah. We try to keep our hospitals, their internal blood banks in the hospital stocked at all times.
30 hospitals around the Central Valley, as I understand it.
That's correct. And so they each have a blood supply in their hospitals, and we supply that and keep it stocked. And so at any given moment, they have a supply, but as soon as a accident happens, we may need to go get it from another hospital if we don't have it in-house.
It's kind of like having money in the bank, and then if you need it for an emergency, it goes down.
It goes down. It's your reserve fund.
Right. Basically, that's what it is. All right, caller, you're on the air with Dean Eller. Go ahead.
Hi, I'm live, right?
Yeah, you're on. Go ahead.
Mr. Eller.
Yes.
It's a pleasure to speak with you again. You have done an excellent job. And I am coming up on my ninth gallon.
Wow.
Gallon,
good,
not pint.
Yeah.
I have great respect for what you guys do. If there was one thing that would be make it easier for me, is if there was the old site, be able to take my donations so I don't have to go so far north. I live in the town of Fowler.
Uh-huh. Well,
so, anything in the south part of town a possibility?
We've got two maps, Dean, of the other two locations. Do you want to put them up and so we can show them?
Well, there's nothing. You can. Neither one of those are too far south. We have obviously from the old facility. We have when we closed the old facility, we actually opened up a center at Shaw and Sixth.
Okay.
And so that's
where I go.
Yeah, and so that's the one we have there. That's kind of the furthest one south, unless you go down to our Visalia facility. But we do have 7 blood mobiles that are out in the community, and most people can go on our website, donateblood.org, and they can find out where a mobile drive. Usually there's one near someone because we send them out into the 5-county area. So we've got them all over the place. We have several blood drives. In the Fowler, Reed Lee, Kingsburg area all the time.
I have been in the blood mobile several times and in different towns, and that does make it a little easier, but I have what you guys call baby blood, and you always want me to come in every 8 weeks, and I am glad to do that, but to go way out to the northwest part of town is not convenient.
Well, again, we certainly hopefully when the economy gets better and we can expand, well, then we certainly will go south and probably east at some point. But right now we have to rely on those blood mobiles to get them out closest to you.
Yeah, and it does make it very nice. The community comes together here in Fowler for sure. But to be able to do it on a regular 8-week basis, I have to drive at least to Shaw. Is it possible that you could reopen the old blood bank?
We don't own that facility any longer. We sold it when we built a new facility, so it's not there. But the old facility, I believe, is only about a mile and a half difference in the distance between the two.
You may be correct. It just feels far.
Yeah, I hear you. I understand what you're saying.
Yeah. How can this caller or anyone else find out about where those mobile units are? What number can they call?
They can actually go on our website,
okay,
donateblood.org, and we list them out usually months in advance. You can call 389-5433, which is our main number.
Say that again,
389-5433.
Mm-hmm.
And then they'll be able to tell you.
Or go on to donateblood.org. You can do that as well and find out where those mobile units are if they're close to you. And can you request a unit to come close to your area?
You know, what we really encourage people to do is start a blood drive of their own and talk to our staff. And if you can get 15 to 20 people that you know that want to donate, from your business, from your school, from your community, just your neighbors. We'll send a blood mobile out there. We'll schedule it and send it out there.
But you should have at least a minimum of 15 people,
We need 15 to 20 people on a minimum just to make it efficient for us, cost-wise, right. Sending staff out there, sure.
Right. Okay, go on to donateblood.org if you can, if you want to donate or find out where one of those mobile units are going to be located, so you can drive out there, or like Dean said, just start your own blood drive, or you can call 389-5433. Nonetheless, no matter what you decide to do, the blood center is in short supply. The blood is in short supply. So go out and donate if you are healthy enough, if you possibly can. Only your doctor can answer that question. 436 MeTV option 11. We've got the CEO of the Blood Center here in our studio today. Sam Suits and Tuxedos, our sponsor out of Clovis.
The following is another list of things you will not hear on MeTV programs. Man cave, baby bump, whatevs, double half calf mochaccino, faux hawk, redonkulous, totes adorbs, hella, holla, YOLO, cray cray, and MeTV is still Kardashian free. This is what you will hear on MeTV programs.
Bang! Welcome, Denim.
The Twilight Zone.
About bulls.
I object, Your Honor.
Mr. Grant.
I hear you right.
You heard me right.
MeTV. Thanks for listening.
Nothing better than showing up to your next big event in a new suit or tuxedo. Sam's Men's Suits and Tuxedo Shop on Clovis Avenue, just south of Old Town Clovis, has provided a wide selection of custom tailored fine suits and accessories for over 25 years. Right now, get two suits, two shirts, two ties, and a pair of shoes for only $199. Act now and get a third suit for only $50 more. Stop by or call 559-298-6063 to schedule your fitting today at Sam's Men's Suits and Tuxedo Shop.
Back here with Dean Eller. He is obviously the CEO of the Blood Center, and it's called the Central California Blood Center out there at Herndon and Blythe. That's the main office, 389-5433. Blood is in short supply, and there is the location there. Caller, you've been waiting. Go ahead. What's your question?
Dean, I'd like to ask you a real quick question. Your donors that give blood, do they have to be in perfect condition in order to give, or I don't mean someone that is real sick, but how about someone that has had a heart attack 15 years ago, but it's in good health? Can they give blood, or you take take tests to make sure that the blood's good? That's really what I want to know.
Well, the simple answer to that is, as long as your doctor thinks you're healthy, then most likely you will be able to. We are concerned with anyone who has had a health problem in the past. We want to make sure that they are healthy too, and that we're not going to harm them. But a lot of people who have had heart problems in the past can donate. It depends on what kind of medication you may or may not be on. If you're not on any medication, it should be fine. There are some medications that are good and some that are not. And so it's a matter of just giving us a call or coming in, and we'll let you know.
Okay. I appreciate that call very much. Here is someone here donating blood the other day at the Central California Blood Center. And you should always check with your doctor, because it does matter what kind of medication you take. Am I right about that?
Yeah. Most medications are okay.
What medications are really kind of a no-no?
The ones that you can for sure bank on. If you're on antibiotics, you can't give until you've been off of them for a couple of days. So if you're on antibiotics, don't come in until you're well. And that's the key. Are you feeling well today and healthy today? But blood thinners are usually a no-no. Those types of things. But a lot of people, like even diabetics, can give if they're on medication, they're under control, and again, their doctor clears them to donate. So most medications are okay. Some of the drugs for prostate cancer and those types of things, obviously, are no-no, but most are okay.
If you're under cancer treatment, probably not a good idea to get.
No, you can't. If you've got to be past. It depends on the type of cancer, but you've got to be pass it. Some people have skin cancers, and once those are taken off and healed and we've gone through a little bit, a lot of times those are okay to come back in on.
All right. And interesting that you said blood thinners, because a lot of my viewers know that I had a couple of stents put in, and I'm on a certain kind of blood thinner, not a heavy dose, but a certain one. So would that disqualify me?
Well, your overall health is probably going to disqualify you, because you're still recovering from a lot of different things. But most of the blood thinners are going to eliminate you, just because of what it's doing to the blood in you. And of course, we don't want to pass that on to a patient.
So you don't want someone donating blood that has had their blood thinned out by a blood thinner.
If you're off of them, that's okay. But if you're on them right now, it's probably best for you not to.
Because the blood is too thin?
It alters the blood, right?
Mm-hmm. So it's just not going to work.
Right.
Right. All right, let's roll another piece of videotape. I have a lot of questions here. 436-ME-TV, option 11. Dean Eller is here, the CEO of the Central California Blood Center. Let's roll a videotape on pumping for blood, and that's what we like to see. A lot of people coming in and drawing blood and donating blood. And a couple of questions. How long does it take, and what kind of paperwork do you have to fill out once you get into the blood center? Generally speaking, once you walk through the door, you'll be out in, 30, 40, 50 minutes?
Yeah, it should be out in 45 minutes max, unless we're just really swamped with people. But you go in once you register, which only takes a couple minutes, and then you go into the little screening booth, and that should probably take about 15 minutes total to answer the questions and make sure you're well and healthy. And then once you get in the chair is only 5, 6, 7 minutes of drawing your blood. So then the vast majority of the time after that is getting some great snacks in our canteen.
Yeah, no, I've seen the snacks there. Wish I could have some of those. Now, this gentleman here is sitting down drawing blood. How much, generally speaking, do you draw out of a person? Does it depend on the size of the person?
Well, you have to weigh at least 110 pounds, but we
donate
blood.
Hang on, caller. Pardon me?
We take one pint of blood.
Pint mm-hmm. from each person.
But the average person, average adult, has 10 to 12 pints of blood in their body at all times.
Okay. All right. Caller, you've been patient. Go ahead. You're on the air.
Yeah. Good morning. Good morning, John. Good morning, Dean. Here's another question of the day. For me, I'm a small person. I have never given blood. I have my reservations. I'm 5'2", 115. Okay, here's a question. Do you think that they would ever have a half a pint of blood given? They make a way for only give for small people to give a half a pint of blood. And well, that's my question for now, Dean. I appreciate your being there, too.
Thank you. No, we don't consider doing a half a pint. Again, we do everything by regulation, and that's the amount the FDA assess. There's a certain amount of milliliters that they require.
So there's a standard from
there
the
is
FDA
a standard, yes.
as to how much you need to draw out
right.
from a person, and
right.
that's one pint.
One pint.
Okay.
But you know, someone who's 5'2" and weighs 115 pounds, that is not. You still have 10 to 12, you know, probably 10 to 12 pints of blood in your system at all times. So it's not going to affect you one way or another. We have a lot of women who are 5 feet tall and weigh 115 pounds that give all the time, and they do just fine.
So if he gives one pint of blood, no problem. It's not going to affect him.
It should be. I mean, for most people, it is not. You know, there are some people who might get faint, that type of thing. But that depends on a lot of different areas. Whether did they eat a good meal before they came in? Did they hydrate before they came in? If you do the things that we ask you to do on our website, then you really shouldn't have a problem. Most people get really faint because they have anxiety over giving. It's a very safe procedure, and we're not going to take it if it's going to do you harm.
Right. And so when you say that, you know, they have to, what are some of the things that they should eat, and what's the time period before giving blood that you should eat something? Would it be protein? Maybe drink a protein drink, eat a banana, Have some chips? What should they do?
All and any of the above, but you should hydrate before you come in.
Water?
So, water. You should be hydrated. You should, we say eat a meal, but any kind of a meal where you're getting protein and carbohydrates back into your system to help you with that donation. And then that's why we send you to the canteen afterwards, because then we want to replenish whatever you've had. So we add back to that.
Right. Okay, 436, MeTV, option 11. Dean Eller is here, the CEO of the Central California Blood Center out at Herndon and Blythe. That's in northwest Fresno, not too far from Highway 99. You can call in and ask your question. Plenty of phone lines open here on this Tuesday morning. Sam Suits and Tuxedos is our sponsor today here on Connect With Me on MeTV Fresno.
Want to create something extraordinary? Create perfection. Our lifestyle appliances make it easy. KitchenAid, Ventura TV Appliance, and you, when only the best will do.
There's nothing better than showing up to your next big event in a new suit or tuxedo. Sam's Men's Suits and Tuxedo Shop on Clovis Avenue, just south of Old Town Clovis, has provided a wide selection of custom-tailored fine suits and accessories for over 25 years. Right now, get two suits, two shirts, two ties, and a pair of shoes for only $199. Act now and get a third suit for only $50 more. Stop by or call 559-298-6063 to schedule your fitting today at Sam's Men's Suits and Tuxedo Shop.
All right, if you have a question, you can call in at 436-ME-TV, option 11. Dean Eller is here. There is a shortage of blood. And are you talking about all blood types, Dean?
Right now.
Everything?
Every blood type right now we can take.
Wow, everything under the sun, huh?
We are short on every blood type right now.
All right, hang on, caller. Get to you in a moment. And that includes the universal blood type, which is O?
O negative.
O negative.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
O positive is the most common and the most used. And so we always need that. O negative is a universal donor, and it's the universal donor because any blood type can receive an O negative unit of blood. But conversely, an O negative can only receive another O negative. And so for those of us, which I am, that are O negative.
You're an O negative?
I am an O negative.
And you can only receive an O negative.
That's correct. And my daughter, Jenny, was an O negative. My wife and son are both O negative. So when
you donate blood, anybody can get that blood, right?
That's correct.
Universal.
That's correct. That's what's used in emergency rooms or with preemie babies and those types of things.
Right. Probably U.S. military uses that, I'm sure.
Well, they
universal.
Use it. Every emergency room in the United States and certainly in the military has to have a supply of O negative.
Yeah, because it's universal.
Correct.
All right. Caller, you're on the air. Go ahead.
Really quick. Please have your guests say what promotions are coming up and what dates are coming up as far as what would be received by somebody that actually gives a pint.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Got any promotions coming up here that we might be interested in?
I don't. Well, we just had a big one this past Saturday that you missed, which was the NFL for Life, and all the NFL teams, booster clubs were out there donating blood.
Including the Raiders and 49ers?
All of them. And Rams, I think, were there. The Redskins were there.
We don't like those teams.
It was great because and we got several hundred units of blood as a result of it.
That's great.
The things that are coming up right on the horizon, I think you can get off our website.
Mm-hmm.
But the big ones that are going on right now are mainly our high school drives and college drives are the big ones that are going on right now. And again, I don't know the exact dates of those, but those are on our website.
Okay, let me ask you a couple of email questions here as we roll the videotape and show you some more people donating blood out there at Herndon and Blythe. Here's an email viewer, a viewer emailing a question. How long does it take an average person to recover from donating blood?
Really, it's the average person, and I would consider myself an average person.
Okay.
and I, talking to your caller a little bit ago that was at 9 gallons. I'm on my 15th gallon. And
wow.
And I recover really almost immediately. There's not a whole lot going on with me, especially after I get a couple package of ho-ho's down my down my belly. But the main thing, you know, you're replenishing your blood supply almost immediately. You're starting to make them again. Your
body makes blood
all the time. And in fact, I think your entire body replaces itself in blood every 120 days anyway. So you're just continually going.
So when I cut myself shaving and I'm like bleeding out, don't worry about it, right? Because I'm being replenished.
It's gonna as soon as you plug that gap, it's gonna replenish itself.
We're kind of joking around here a little bit, but a serious topic certainly in giving blood. And you see this gentleman here, kind of relaxing. You can bring a book in. I imagine you can bring your iPad in, cell phone.
Yeah.
Relax, do some reading. And just donate blood. Hey, how about another question here? And this is a very important question. I want people at home to listen up to this. If they are near a phone, you can call in and get more details about this. A viewer emailed a question, actually texted the question, can people donate to any local hospital and will the blood get to you?
Can they donate for a hospital or at a hospital?
At a hospital.
No, all of the blood donation is come through us. Now we have blood drives at the hospitals. We have yearly blood drives at every one of our hospitals, but every blood donation comes back to the Jenny Eller Donor Center, to the lab there, and is processed there, and then it goes out from there to the community, to all 30 hospitals. So it's all the blood mobiles will bring everything back to our facility every day. We process it, test it, and then send it out to where it's needed.
But say I can't go to St. Agnes or a community hospital and say, hey, I want to donate some blood.
No.
Can't happen.
No, they're not equipped to take blood and process it and test it the way we do.
Okay. All right.
Per FDA regulations. So.
Right. Hey, another email question, and this is a very interesting one. Okay. Age limitations. What's the youngest you can be? What's the oldest you can be?
Well, let's go with the oldest first. There is no upper age limit at all, okay, as long as you are healthy, as long as you're well healthy. We have donors that come in and do plasma right now. I can think of one that's 94 years old that comes in every month and donates a plasma. On the younger side, 16 years old with written parental consent, and 17 years old without. So you can be 16 as long as you have written parental consent.
As long as we're looking at this video right here, I want to ask you, what are platelets? What is plasma? What are those those are like medical terms to me, okay? What does that mean in terms of blood?
Those are the names of blood components. So you have blood, and inside your blood you have red blood cells, white blood cells, platelets, and plasma. Platelets are the sticky little cells that we take out of the red blood donations that are used for leukemia patients, people who need clotting factors and that type of thing. Plasma is also used for volume in burn victims. So a lot of plasma is used in burn victims and in a lot of traumas. There's many different uses for both of those, but those are the main things that they go to.
So like one of our favorite people, I've never met him, but Pete Dern, uh-huh, the fireman,
uh-huh,
who was badly burned,
right,
just within the last couple of years. We've all seen that video of him tragically falling through that roof there. So in his case, he had, you know, all sorts of skin grafts and operations. In his case, he would need plasma, right?
Yeah, he probably used a little bit of all of the above, but
including the platelets,
possibly.
Okay.
Possibly so. The main thing he used were plasma, and then a byproduct of plasma is cryoprecipitate, and those all again give you volume and help with the healing on burn victims, because you need that. You've lost a lot of fluid and you need it back.
So on a burn victim, if you the more plasma you have, it'll help in the healing process.
Yes.
Wow, I didn't know that. Okay, very interesting. All right, Dean Eller is here. He's the CEO of the Central California Blood Center out there at Herndon and Blythe. Some very good information. And if you want to donate, you can. All you have to do is go to the website, go to donateblood.org. You can go on there. They have all sorts of information on where you can go to donate blood, or you can call 389-5433 and to get an operator. Once you get the recording, you just hit zero. Very simple process. Today's program, Connect With Me, is sponsored by Sam Suits and Tuxedos out there in Clovis. Go check them out. Back in a moment.
The Justice Network is here. If you haven't tuned in, you're missing a great lineup of gripping stories of real crime, plus an unprecedented effort by viewers like you to play an active role in making your community safer. You can help support law enforcement by providing information that may lead to the apprehension of dangerous criminals or find a missing child. Great shows and your chance to fight crime, only on the Justice Network.
Nothing better than showing up to your next big event in a new suit or tuxedo. Sam's Men's Suits and Tuxedo Shop on Clovis Avenue, just south of Old Town Clovis, has provided a wide selection of custom tailored fine suits and accessories for over 25 years. Right now, get two suits, two shirts, two ties, and a pair of shoes for only $199. Act now and get a third suit for only $50 more. Stop by or call 559-298-6063 to schedule your fitting today at Sam's Men's Suits and Tuxedo Shop.
All right, I want to read a headline, Dean, from the Channel 30 website, and it says, weather having an impact on blood banks as they are facing the worst deficit in 30 years? Yeah. Is that true? In 30 years?
Yeah. I've been here almost 18. I can tell you it's the most since I've been there, and the most prolonged. You know, every once in a while we'll have just a major thing happens, and we're really short for a day or two or three. But this has been going on now all winter long, and so weather has had an impact, but certainly colds and flu have also.
But you think back 20 years, that's what, 1997, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. You think back 10 more years, that's 1987, so the worst deficit since 1987?
Yeah. Yeah, no, it's...
In terms of shortage, blood shortage.
In shortage, and,
wow.
we're measuring that on the length of the shortage. Again, you could have had one day where you were just out.
Down to zero.
Yeah. But this is has been constant. So that's what keeps me up at night.
Has there been a steady decline in the last couple of years? Have you noticed?
It ebbs and flows. But if you want to look at it year over year, there has been a steady decline.
And you can't give a reason for that, I'm sure.
Well,
because no one knows why people do or decide to go in or decide not to donate.
Yeah, I mean, it's all what's going on in people's life and how motivated they are to get in to donate. It also depends on the needs and how much advertising we're putting out and getting the word out that we need it. You know, sometimes when we're really good, we don't advertise it as much, and then people forget.
Right.
And so it's a constant reminder, reminding people that they need to come in.
Here's a question that I've heard a lot from various people whenever this donating blood issue comes up. And that is, when you donate blood, does it get tested for everything? We hear so many topics and issues about sexually transmitted diseases here in the Central Valley, teen pregnancy and all that kind of stuff. So when one donates, are they going to find out if they have the AIDS virus, if they have syphilis, if they have this disease, that disease, you name it, whatever's on the books?
Mm-hmm.
Does it get, where does it go? Now, we saw the monologue piece, so we kind of touched on it there, but where does the blood go, and does it get tested for everything across the board?
Well, once you donate blood, if you're at the Jenny Eller Donor Center, once you donate blood, it goes about 100 feet behind you.
Okay.
And that's where it's tested. It's tested right there at our facility. It's a state-of-the-art laboratory. And
right.
And we certainly test for HIV and for all of the hepatitis.
Hepatitis, yeah.
We're testing for Zika now.
Oh, you are?
We test for West Nile virus.
Mm-hmm.
We have what's called NAT testing or nucleic acid testing. Very sensitive, very sophisticated test. And we'll pick up viral loads from hepatitis or HIV within really a day or two of infection. So they're very sensitive.
Yeah. Now, back when I was living in New York many years ago, maybe 25 years ago now, there was a huge story regarding Arthur Ashe, mm-hmm. who had had bypass surgery. And he needed some blood transfusions. And Arthur Ashe, the world-class, world-renowned tennis star that won Wimbledon, of course. He won. He was a Grand Slam winner and very famous at the time. And I don't know if the younger generation knows who Arthur Ashe is, but because of the blood transfusions, he contracted HIV.
Yes.
And tragically passed away. Mm-hmm. One of the all-time great athletes, of course, and tennis stars of our generation. How well is the concentrated effort to test this blood to make sure that it's 100% clean?
Well,
and can it be 100% clean?
Well, nothing is ever 100%. But let me give you a little history. From in 1985 is when the government and the blood centers finally and physicians finally figured out what was causing the infections for HIV and how they were coming through blood. That was 1985. And from then on is when we started testing. And the tests have gotten better and better and better as we've gone forward. Today, it's almost unheard of to pass on through a blood donation HIV. Mm-hmm. Almost unheard of. Because this test will pick it up. And also hepatitis. It's almost unheard of in today's testing that you're ever going to have that problem.
Yeah.
I'll tell you how confident I am. My daughter received hundreds of units of blood. I mean, literally hundreds. And of course, obviously didn't have a problem. But that's how safe the testing. I wouldn't even think about not going through my local blood center, and not only ours, but blood centers across the country.
Right, because I think a lot of people are concerned. You know, even in this day and age, you know, if they go to the hospital, they need an operation. You know, I know I've had blood transfusions in the past too. In fact, mine was in the 90s, and so I was a little concerned about it. You know, is the blood that the hospital is giving me, is it clean? Has it been tested? Should anyone worry about that at all?
I would not. I mean,
okay.
Again, as we talked earlier, nothing is 100%, but the
yeah.
odds of that are pretty remote.
Yeah. So there's another person giving blood there. We probably should take another break here because we're getting close to the end of the show. Now we'll talk a little bit about your daughter, who sadly passed away back in 1995, Jenny Eller. Named her name is, of course, on that blood center at Herndon and Blythe. 436-ME-TV, option 11. Dean Eller is here, CEO of the Central California Blood Center. Back in just a moment after this from Sam Suits and Tuxedos out in Clovis.
When you like Ventura TV Appliance on Facebook, it's nice. But when you love the KitchenAid appliances we deliver, it's even better. Our website is cool, and it's a good place to start. But you really should touch the merchandise before you buy. Save big with KitchenAid. Right now, get up to a $1,000 prepaid MasterCard when you purchase select KitchenAid appliances. Get the best selection, price, and service in town without waiting. Come in to Ventura TV Appliance and touch the merchandise today.
Nothing better than showing up to your next big event in a new suit or tuxedo. Sam's Men's Suits and Tuxedo Shop on Clovis Avenue, just south of Old Town Clovis, has provided a wide selection of custom tailored fine suits and accessories for over 25 years. Right now, get two suits, two shirts, two ties, and a pair of shoes for only $199. Act now and get a third suit for only $50 more. Stop by or call 559-298-6063 to schedule your fitting today at Sam's Men's Suits and Tuxedo Shop.
All right, back here with Dean Eller, of course. 436-ME-TV, option 11 is the telephone number if you want to call in and ask a question. Some remaining minutes here with Dean. Do want to put the photo back up of your daughter, Jenny Eller, who sadly passed away back in 1995 in October. She was a wonderful athlete, went out to Bullard High School. She played softball out there. And then one day you found out that she had leukemia, but just reading some of the information online about Jenny, she had more courage, it sounds like to me, than a lot of people when they face this kind of thing. I know I'd be scared to death, but she had courage.
She did. I'll tell you a little story. When she was diagnosed, now she was 18 years old, had just turned 18 years old when we discovered some bruising and went into the hospital and she was being diagnosed with leukemia. And I can remember the day that the doctor told her and basically gave her a death sentence and said, this type of leukemia is a killer. I mean, he used those exact words. And wow. She, 18 years old, we got up, we left. The two of us were driving in my car home, and she'd been silent for a long time, looking out the passenger side window. And I finally broke the silence and said, Jenny, so what do you think? What do you think about all this? She goes, she just turned to me and looked at me and she said, Dad, I just don't want you and Mom to be sad because I'm not sad. Because I know no matter what happens, I'm in God's hands. And it'll be all right. And she says, I have a little anxiety over the treatment of the chemo and the radiation, those types of things, but I'm not worried. And at that moment, if you want to look at it figuratively, I believe that 18-year-old little girl picked me up and put me on her shoulders, and she literally carried me for the next 4 years as she fought this killer disease.
Right. She wasn't scared to die, basically. She had faith in God.
She did. And it was evident to everyone who knew her. And so she spent the rest of her life, you know, 18-year-olds, you get a death sentence, you want to travel the world, you know, you want to quit school. She didn't do any of those things. She actually stepped up her schooling. She was taking 20 units a semester when she died. She didn't want to travel. She wanted to tell people what the need was for blood donations, because blood donors were literally keeping her alive. John, she could not live from 1 week into the next without several blood transfusions just to get her into the next week. Her body did not make any blood, so for nearly 4 years, people of the Central Valley kept her alive.
Yeah, and that's why it's so important to donate. There's no question about that.
And she's not the only one out there. I mean, they're right now at Children's Hospital. There's several like her. In every hospital here in the state, there are several that are waiting for donors to come in because they need them.
Week in and week out, they need that blood to stay alive.
There's no holiday for the for blood donation. There's no holiday for any of these leukemia patients or cancer patients or trauma victims. Or if your loved one gets in an accident this afternoon and ends up in the emergency room, that blood has to be tested on the shelf, ready to go. And the only way that they can do that is if a wonderful anonymous donor comes in, donates blood 2 days earlier, so that blood will be there. Most people want to say, hey, if my wife gets in an accident, my church is big and we'll send hundreds of people down there and they'll give. Well, you know what? All those hundreds of people won't do your wife any good, because it was the wonderful anonymous donor who gave 2 days earlier that's going to save her life, not you or your church. And so that's why it's important. We really want people to come in all the time. Don't wait for a tragedy to happen. You talked about Captain Dern. People came in and donated. It was wonderful for him. But the people that were saving his life in the emergency room those first few days were the people who came in 2 or 3 days earlier.
Prior to his accident.
That's correct. And so
those are the ones that saved his life.
Those are the ones that were critical to saving his life. Now, the others, the donate kept him going. But when you're in the emergency room, you want the person who was the volunteer donor that came in that thought about it beforehand.
Right. So what you're saying is basically, in a nutshell, don't wait for an accident to happen, because by then it's too late.
It's correct.
So do it beforehand.
It's not too late. It's too late
for your loved one. Yeah, for your loved one or for yourself. If you're in an accident, certainly it'd be too late for you. Okay, so if I have an accident, heaven forbid, it's not going to help me for you to donate on that same day. It would have to be somebody who donated 2 or 3 days prior.
Yeah, it's going to be in the emergency room, it's going to be somebody who's donated two or three days prior. But if somebody, your loved one, came in to donate on the day you had the accident, they're the ones that are going to help sustain your life over the next few days if you continue to need blood.
Once I donate, let's say I donate a pint, and it's all good to go, you've tested it, you put it in storage, how long does it last?
The FDA will allow us to store blood for 42 days.
And then what happens to it after that?
Well, if it's not used, it has to be destroyed.
42 days?
Yes, but it never makes it that far. Again, most You're blood centers kidding. Only have a day to maybe 3 days supply of blood. And so it's not going to make it 42 days.
Are you guys as shocked as I? So that basically is a little more than a month.
Yeah.
It's a month and 1 week.
Yeah.
42 days, that's how long it lasts.
Mm-hmm.
I'm shocked by that. I thought I thought the answer would be 2 or 3 months.
No.
Not the case.
No, 42 days.
That's why it's so important to donate, right?
Right. Well, it's important because actually we're turning that blood supply over every few days, not 42 days. We need it right now.
No, you turn it over way before the 42 right. days. There's no question about it. And there is a shortage right now. And I do want to give that phone number out one more time before we go, but short on time now. But I do want to ask this critical question. There might be some people out there wondering, okay, I want to donate money. But what's more important right now? Is it donating blood or donating money? What would be number one?
It's always donating blood.
Okay.
That's always the most important thing to me. We'll find a way to get the money that we need if we need to. But there's no substitute for that life-saving red stuff that comes out of your veins. There's no substitute.
No substitute. You can't manufacture it.
And it's perishable. And so we have to use it, obviously, quickly. So.
Yeah. Women who are pregnant, can they come in and donate if they want?
No.
They cannot?
No, and the reason for that is we are concerned, obviously, about the health of the mother and the baby, and there's really no need for them to come in during that period of time. Let's err on the side of safety.
How long do they have to wait until after they give birth?
Oh, 6 weeks, 6-8 weeks.
Okay,
their body just needs to recover.
All right. And then your recovery time once you get blood is almost immediate. We've already talked about that. And I do want to put up the maps one more time. I only got about a minute or two left here in the program. So, Dean, we got Herndon and Blythe, and the other two locations are?
Champlain and Perrin.
Okay.
And Shaw and Sixth.
Okay. And those are the two.
Or Mooney Boulevard and Visalia.
Okay. And that's part of your blood center as well, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. We got another phone call here. Very quickly here because we have to go. Caller, we got about 10 seconds. Quickly, what's your question? Quick.
Mr. Eller, I just found out I did surpass 9 gallons.
And oh, that's the caller for the one of the first callers. Okay.
And put another pint in. I am going to keep going whether or not I get any type of recognition, whether or not I get any type of a bonus prize.
Okay.
I care about my fellow man, and I know you do too.
Yeah,
thank you for your service.
Thank you very much.
That's admirable.
Yeah, and people who go in and donate should not be looking for any kind of recognition. It's just an honorable thing to do, no question.
It is. It's you're saving up to 3 lives with every pint of blood.
And really? So,
yeah, because we take the red cells, but we also take it back to the lab and separate the components, and so we separate the plasma and the platelets.
All right. Go to donateblood.org if you want to. That's the website, or you can call the blood center at 389-5433. Glad you called in today and all the email and text questions. I appreciate that. Dean Eller, always good to see you,
my friend.
Thank you,
John.
You're a friend of this program. You can come on anytime you want.
Thank you.
All right. Thank you for being here, Dean, and thank you for watching. Back tomorrow with Ronnie Paul, and we'll talk about the Super Bowl coming up this Sunday, along with the passing of the great one, Mary Tyler Moore. See you then. Have a great day.
If you have a need to promote your business or event, please consider MeTV Fresno for your next campaign. MeTV reaches over 100,000 of your potential customers in the Fresno area every single week. Plus, you can rest assured that your commercial is running in the greatest family-friendly programs of all time. MeTV Fresno delivers a strong, loyal audience ready to buy, and your campaign will cost a fraction of what you're paying for your advertising now. Call me today to find out how affordable MeTV is at 905-1925.
Nothing better than showing.